Hello and welcome to techsith tutorials. Today we are going to learn about static class methods in JavaScript. We'll first start with the difference between instance method and a class method, where class method being the static method. Then we look at the equivalent method when we're not using classes. And then in the end, we look at a practical example of where we should use this static methods. By the way, all the examples that we learn in this tutorial are going to be on techsith.com site, so you can look at them in the detail and practice it. They're all going to be in JS Fiddle. I'll provide a link in the description. Also, if you can help me translate this video into whichever language that you speak, so your countrymen can also learn JavaScript if they don't know English. And third, please become my Patreon if you haven't done so. The link is going to be in the description. All right, so let's get to coding. So I'm going to build my first class and then add a static method to it. So the class going to be car. So I'm just gonna say class car. And inside, I'm just gonna have a simple static method. And the way you write static method is by putting static keyword in front of a method. So I'm just gonna say static, and I'm gonna have a method called compare price. Now it's not compare price right now, but I'm just gonna show you how it works. So inside, all it's gonna do is console.dir, and it's gonna print this. I'm going to do this because I want to, when I call it, I want to know what is being called. And so the way you call it is you call directly on the class itself. So I would say car dot compare price, and let's say what it would give me. So if I run this, I would get the class car back. So basically, static methods are called on the class. So the difference between the static method and instance method is the instance methods are called on the instance of a class. So when I take the class and create objects from it, basically instances of the class, I can call the instance method on them, these objects. But class method, which is static method, are directly called on the class itself. So that's why I'm calling it on the car. Now let's create an instance method. So I'm just gonna add another method called getColor. As you can see, there is no static in front of it, so it's an instance method. And it will do the same thing. It will just say console.dir this. And now I have to create an instance of this car. So I'm gonna say const new car equal to new car. And so now I create an instance of a class, and now I can call an instance method on this. So I would say get color, and let's run this. All right, so the first one, which is a new car, is giving me a car object. And the second one is giving me class car. If I expand the class, I would see the compare price directly inside the class. Remember, it's not a prototype method. In last tutorial, we looked at the class and subclasses in detail, and when you add an instance method, it goes in the prototype. As you can see, there's a prototype, and inside the prototype, I would see the getColor method here. However, the static method goes inside the class. It doesn't go in its prototype. So that's the main difference. When I look at the object car, you won't find the static method. You would only see the class method, which is getColor. All right, so now let's add proper constructor and make this more useful example. So I'm just gonna say constructor, and this would have two properties. The first is going to be color, and then second is going to be price. And inside, what it will do, it will set the initial property for this class, and I'm just gonna use object dot assign this and color price. Again, I'm using object dot assign, so I don't have to do this dot color equal to color, this dot price equal to price. If you don't know what object or assign is, I have a tutorial. I'll provide a link here. All right, and then the getColor method would be simply this dot, I would just say return this dot color. And now comes to the static method. So what is going to be used for? See how the getColor is actually using this dot color inside its body. A static method doesn't use this to access the properties. Static methods are basically used for sort of like utility functions. So here in this compare price, what I want to do is I want to compare price of two different cars. So I can pass car one object and car two object. Now this is going to be instances of this car. So it's going to be objects. And inside what I'm going to do is I'm just going to say return math.absolute car one's price minus cars two's price. As you can see, I'm not using this dot price or anything. Basically what it does, it's not using objects properties. Instead, it would use the parameters that it's been passed. It's not setting or getting anything to the object itself. So now let's create two cars. So I'm going to say const red car equal to new car. Now remember, it has two properties, color. So this is going to be red, and it's going to say $100. That's a cheap car. And the second car is going to be blue car. And it's gonna have a color blue, and its price gonna be $102. The blue car is a little bit expensive than the red car. I don't know why. Usually the red car is supposed to be more flashy and more expensive, but who cares? And now in the compare price, I'm just gonna pass red car and blue car. And let's put the console log in front of both. So when I run this, now here it says new car, I should say red car got dot color. And when I run this, the first one gives me the red, because the red car, as I get color, it gives me the property back red. And the price compare basically compares the price of the red car and a blue car, and it gives me the difference between two, which is $2. So here the compare price is a nice utility function for the car object that doesn't manipulate any properties, but it provides a utility to compare prices. Let's say if I wanna do convert mile per gallon to kilometer per gallon as a utility, I can write another utility function, which would be a static method. And it would basically take mile per gallon, and it would return the converted to kilometer per gallon. But it has nothing to do with the car object itself, but it provides a car related utility. Now when you extend a class to make a subclass can also have a static method, and class can also have static method. So let's look at how it works. So let's look at a little different example, but this is also going to be a class car. All right, so I have a class car, and I have a constructor which simply sets the price. And I'm gonna have a static method called sell car, which basically takes car as an argument. Now this is not a class, it's a object. So don't confuse with this, because there's a capital here. And inside the body, it would basically return selling for, and then I'm just gonna put the price, so this dot price. Now let's extend this car object, so I can say class Toyota extends car. So I'm creating Toyota from the class car, and it would also have price, and I'm just gonna say super price because I don't want to have Toyota's own properties. And it can have its own static method with the same name. So it can say sell car. And it would also have car object passed. But here it would say return Toyota super dot sell car. And it would pass car here. All right, so I have a class car and I have a subclass called Toyota. Now let's create an object from this Toyota. So I can say const Camry equal to new Toyota. And the price is $100. It's really cheap Camry. And I'm just gonna say console log Toyota dot sell car. And I'm just gonna pass this Camry object here. And let's see what I get. So remember, it's calling on the class, which is Toyota, not on the object. It passes the object inside. So if I run this, it gives me Toyota selling for undefined. Why? Remember, this.price is supposed to be car.price because you're not supposed to call this inside the static method. So that's why it's giving me undefined. I'm gonna say run again, it's giving me Toyota selling for $100. So it works. All right, that's all about static class methods. And we are closing to the end of this larger series on object-oriented JavaScript. And if you haven't started from the beginning, you can do so. I'll provide a link here. But we still have a couple of tutorials left. We still need to do decorators and class mixins we haven't done. So that's next. And I hope you liked the tutorial. And if you did, please like, subscribe, and provide a constructive comment. Thank you.